from News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good morning. Welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Come November, Mainers will vote on gay marriage once again. Today at the State House in Augusta, gay rights advocates announced that they had collected more than 105,000 signatures to force a referendum question on same-sex marriage. Equality Maine and other groups carried the dozens of boxes of petitions and then delivered them to the Secretary of State's office for certification. While supporters say the time is right for another vote, opponents say Mainers have already voted on the issue back in 2009. And the outcome this time, they say, will be the same.
Many people have changed their minds, and many continue to change their minds, and they want another chance to bring fairness and equality to the state of Maine. We are going to give them that chance.
It's going to be another campaign, unfortunately. We are disappointed, as divisive and as contentious as it was in 2009. This is a really tough time to be going through this again.
Well, the opposition says it expects to spend millions of dollars to fight this referendum. Gay rights supporters say they have conducted a poll that shows that 54% of Mainers surveyed now support same-sex marriage. Well, retiring Massachusetts Congressman Barney Frank and his longtime partner Jim Reddy of Maine are planning on getting married in Frank's home state. A spokesman for Frank confirmed the news but did not divulge any further details. The 16-term representative announced in November that he would be retiring from Congress. The Democratic lawmaker disclosed back in 1987 that he was gay. He was the first openly gay member of Congress. The developer looking to build a strip club in the town of Elliott has stopped his lawsuit against the town, at least for now. Developer Donald Nunzio wanted to build a gentleman's club with topless and full nudity at the site of a former daycare located on Route 236. However, the town passed an ordinance prohibiting full nudity and the sale of alcohol, as well as restricting operating hours. The attorney for the proposed club filed a federal lawsuit to fight the ordinances, saying that they violate his client's First Amendment rights. But according to court documents obtained by News 8, the developer has filed to dismiss those claims. Now, the Pentagon is preparing for budget cuts. The cuts are the result of last year's debt ceiling vote when Congress was not able to agree on specific cuts. The Pentagon has to reduce its budget by almost $500 billion over the next 10 years. Today, Secretary of Defense Leon Panetta laid out the plans on how the Defense Department will be trimmed.
In this budget, we plan to gradually resize the active Army to 490,000. That's down from present force level of 562,000. And the active Marine Corps will go to 182,000. That's down from 202,000.
Secretary Panetta says the transition will take place over the next 5 years and will finish in 2017. The budget cuts will begin in October. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. We'll be right back.